Hey guys, so let's take a little break from mechanical keyboards, shall we? I've been playing around with mechanical keyboards so many times that I noticed they have these tiny cool looking chips on their printed circuit boards. These chips are basically the brains of the keyboards. They're called microcontrollers. A microcontroller is an integrated circuit, IC device, used for controlling the electronic system. Now, most of the time, microcontrollers can have many other electronic components within it. This is where the term IC comes in. An IC is a collection of electronic components, resistors, transistors, capacitors, including the microprocessor, all stuffed into one tiny chip. This chip is the core to how your machine or system is able to compute programmatically. So if you type on your mechanical keyboard, it's that IC doing its magic, interacting with your components and sending electrical signals, inputs and outputs to your device. Okay, so another most common IC is called the Arduino board. Arduino is a company that makes these boards used for building electronics projects. Before Arduino boards was invented, using IC was used by experts or at least require good programming skills. Pretty tough. But now Arduino offers students or anyone to use an IC without any experience in electronics. It's more beginner friendly and affordable to many. Hundreds of thousands of designers, engineers, students, and makers around the world are using Arduino to innovate. Remember I said Arduino boards are open sourced, meaning anyone can modify and change the IC to their heart's desire? Well, a team of engineers from Cytron Technologies in Malaysia came up with a version of Arduino called Maker. It's an IC that is designed to be student-friendly and convincingly fun. Not only that, Cytron Maker Place is basically a haven for makers or hobbyists out there to buy electronic components for any projects. So do check out their amazing stuff online. So, if you're probably wondering, why am I telling you this? Well, it's because I'm planning to build a color sorter. I love to create and build, so I thought, why not create a color sorter for my keycaps, right? That was my initial plan, but since I'm very new to digital making, I want to start something small and easy. So I decided to make a color sorting machine for candies instead. And Cytron actually sent me some of their stuff to let me build something. So let's get started because I'm itching to build it.
Oh my gosh, guys. Something came in the mail today, and it's the package. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to build this thing, even though I've never built something before, but yep, it's gonna be challenging, but fun. So let's get into the unboxing. Okay, let's look. Never seen a color sensor before. What? Wow. Impressive. So pretty. Oh, they're so cute. The Maker Uno. I'm in love already.
now, if you just got your starter kit and you're a beginner like me, I really recommend you to set up the software needed to get started on your building process. To do so, set up your Arduino IDE and Tinkercad. For the maker kit, you will need an Arduino IDE to help program your code for your board. To download it, simply just head on to the official Arduino IDE website and click download according to your OS. After unzipping the folder, run the executable file to start up the IDE, which you will use to write your C code. As for the Tinkercad, it's optional, but I really recommend it for beginners. All you need to do is go to tinkercad.com and sign in with an account. Afterwards, just click on circuits, then you can follow a tutorial there and get started. Easy. Tinkercad allows makers to build their virtual circuits online. It's very intuitive and great for constructing circuits, even when you don't have a kit with you yet. Oh, another tip, please play around with your breadboard, as it's a great skill to have when building circuits. Okay, let's start planning the color sorter. Now this is kind of how I want my sorter to look like. The key requirements for this is to have it sort and separate them accordingly to different colors. Now the main components used for this are two servos to move the skittles, one color sensor to detect the different colors, and lastly the main component, the Maker Nano, the brain of the machine. Now we've got it all planned, let's learn how to use the Maker Nano and its components and sensors. I'll be using Tinkercad to go through my circuit and test out my code. It was so fun since I've never actually made circuits before. Honestly, it did take some time to get used to the breadboard, but after watching some couple of tutorials online, it was a breeze. I'm currently creating a simple circuit using some resistors and LED lights and the color sensor. As a computer science student, I gotta say, it was so fun coding and seeing the output physically in front of me through circuits. I'm still very new to digital making, but I can see why people enjoy it, as it can be very rewarding and it gives you the ability to create something. Oh, and the rainbow wires are just so pretty to look at, and peeling them off one by one feels so nice. I mean, I just really like it, I don't know why. Okay, back to the building process. So after fumbling through the wires and components, I finally got the hang of it and managed to test out my color sensor. I tested it out with several color squares to see whether it can detect the colors red, green, and blue. Surprise, surprise, it finally did. So next up is to get the supplies and tools to create it. I'll be using a lot of tape, double-sided and duct tape. Scissors, a sharp cutting knife, glue is definitely a must, that would be the adhesive glue and super glue, a ruler, a pencil, and marker. Oh, and wooden popsicle sticks. You'll see. Oh, let's not forget the main stuff, of course, the Skittle candies. You can use whatever candies you like for this project. As for the main material for the machine, I got a small size box from the local shop. I cut the top to make a slide out of it. This slide will later be attached to a servo to navigate the skittles. As for the tube for the skittles to go into, I recycled an old plastic folder, taped it on the sides, and rolled it into a small tube that would fit the candy. Now, for the three levels and floors in the box, I will be using corrugated plastic sheets. It's like a sheet of plastic that has tiny holes in them. You can use other materials too if you wish. Now for the electronic components, you'll need a USB to micro USB cable to connect your Maker Nano, two micro servos to move the slide and rotator, wires, a must. The wires I'm using are 6 female to male jumper wires and 7 female to female jumper wires. A color sensor. This specific color sensor I'm using is the version TCS3200, and I did have to solder on the pins for this one. Let's not forget the Maker Nano, I really like this. It has more built-in LEDs, a push button, and a harmonious piezo buzzer, something that does not exist on an Arduino Nano board, which means you can create any sounds you like instantly. Just listen to this. You'll also need an expansion shield. This shield is designed to expand the Arduino or Maker Nano's I/O. I/O means the input-output pins. They are expanded out into three-way header pins with SVG, signal voltage ground configuration. Basically, you'll get more pins than usual, so it'll be easier to create circuits. All right, now we've got all our components, let's start building.
Okay, so I finally built the color sorter. Ta-da! Okay, so I actually had to make some changes. I added a shield around the color sensor because I didn't want the external light from interfering with it. I did take some time to do the calibration of the colors, but it kind of worked out. And all that there's left to do is show it to you guys how it works.
All in all, it was so fun making this. If you are looking for the next best hobby or want to use up your time during quarantine or not get bored being trapped at home, get into digital making. Get yourself a maker kit and create something. It could be anything. Plus, it will be a skill worth having. So if you made it till the end of this video, thanks so much for watching.